National Museum of Fine Arts. The neoclassical building was built in 1921 and originally served to house the various legislative bodies of the Philippine government, known as the Old Legislative Building, also the Old Congress Building. It was the home of the bicameral Congress from 1926 to 1972, and the Philippine Senate from. The building was originally designed by the Bureau of Public Works, precursor of the Department of Public Works and Highways, consulting architect Ralph Harrington Doan to and Antonio Toledo in 1918, and was intended to be the future home of the National Library of the Philippines, according to the plan of Manila of Daniel H. Burnham. 3. Meanwhile, a capitol building for the Philippine legislature established on October 16, 1916 was to rise on Wallace Field. Just south of the library, the location is now Mario Y. Orosa Street in Rizal Park. Instead, the Philippine legislature decided to move into the library building in 1926, and changes to the building's layout were done accordingly by architect Juan M. Arellano. 3. It was built under the supervision of the architecture firm of Pedro Ciocci & Company, and the building therefore DECAM, known as the Legislative Building. The second regular session of the 7th Philippine Legislature was formally opened on the inauguration of the building on July 16, 1926, in the presence of Governor General Leonard Wu, then Senate President Manuel L. Quezon, House Speaker Manuel Roxas, and Colonel Carmier Thompson, envoy of President Calvin Coolidge of the United States. Too, it was concurrently the headquarters of the National Library from 1928 to 1944. In 1935, the Commonwealth of the Philippines was proclaimed, and the inauguration of President Manuel L. Quezon were held outside the building. The building became home of the National Assembly of the Philippines, and it was subsequently known as the National Assembly Building in 1940. The National Assembly was replaced by a bicameral Congress of the Philippines, consisting of a Senate and House of Representatives. The Senate occupied the upper floors, while the House occupied the lower floors. The building would serve as home of the Commonwealth Congress until 1945. During World War II, American forces shelled the building during the Battle of Manila in 1945 to flush out Japanese forces who had turned it into a stronghold. Most of the structure was beyond repair, except for the still-standing central portion. With the inauguration of the Republic of the Philippines in 1946, the building was reconstructed to be the home of Congress. It was rebuilt by the U.S. Philippine War Damage Corporation to the same dimensions, but with less interior and exterior ornamentation. Reconstruction began in 1949. While the Congress moved back the same year, the two wings of the building were completed in 1955. The building was rebuilt mostly from memory, with the aid of a few remaining blueprints. The building became known as the Congress Building, and continuously served as home of the Congress of the Philippines until 1972. With the declaration of martial law, the Congress was effectively dissolved, and the building was padlocked for a short time. The building became home of the offices of the Prime Minister of the Philippines, a position established under the 1973 Constitution of the Philippines on the fourth floor, the Ombudsman on the third floor, the National Museum on the second floor, and the Sandiganbayan on the ground floor. To the building was called the Executive House for the duration of that time. The Congress of the Philippines was re-established with the ratification of the 1987 Constitution of the Philippines, while the House of Representatives moved to the Batasang Pambansa Complex in Constitution Hill, Quezon City. The Senate used the original Congress Building for their plenary sessions. The Senate would use the Congress Building until May 1997, when it moved to the Government Service Insurance System Building on reclaimed land on Manila Bay in Pasay. The former office of the Prime Minister was taken as the office of the Vice President. The building was then turned over to the National Museum of the Philippines in 1998. On September 30, 2010, the National Historical Commission of the Philippines declared the building as a National Historical Landmark by virtue of Resolution No. 8 dated September 30, 2010. 3. A marker commemorating the declaration was unveiled on October 29, 2010. Thank you for watching.